everyone, welcome back to PJ's Rhino Jury CAD class. Today's tutorial, we would like to make this fox ring. To make this fox ring, we will need following command. First, we'll go to the Google to find an image and bring it into Rhino with picture frame command. After you bring in, you are going to trace with control point curve. And then you will edit with the control point to get the best curve that you want. With the curve, we will project it to a surface. And then after that, we'll use a helix command to create this double ring shank. And then use the flat spiral command to create this tail. When everything is done, join all the curve, and then you will pipe it to create a ring shank and bowling the ring shank and the face together. Are you ready? Let's get started. All right, let's go to Google. What I did is I type it fox illustration, and then after that you can see all those really awesome image. You can pick any one you like it to trace over. I personally prefer this one because it has really good proportion on the head design. So what you need to do is right click and save image to somewhere you can find it. I already saved one there. Okay, and then we can go back to Rhino. So when we come in to the Rhino, we'll go to the top view, and then we want to type it picture frame to bring in this image. Click on anywhere, make sure you hold the shift so it will be 90 degree proportion to the grid that we have here. It really doesn't matter how big they are right now, you just need to trace the line. So that's zooming, and let me lock the picture so it won't move. All right. So to trace it, I like to use the control point curve on the left. And we just need to zoom in and kind of trace over. And don't worry if it is not completely exactly follow the image, because we need to edit anyway. So do your best to trace the image. And you can also to draw your own graphic if you like to. So let's turn on the control point, which is this icon points on. And then we can kind of, let me turn on my gumball. So we can kind of drag it to fit what we like. Okay. All right, it looks pretty good. All right, so then escape that you can get out of this command, and that's coming in to do the ear. I would like to make sure my near for snap is on, and then all snap is on near, and then so I can snapping into the head. A little bit trick on the tip, if you go from this point to that point, then you are losing the tip there. So I always adding one more point here and one more point there, so that way I can keep the tip more pointed. All right, next one. Again, the tip, you want to give an extra point there. All right, then turn on the control point, do the same thing. We are going to drag it back to this control point again. All right, they look pretty good to me. So at this point, oh, by the way, I also need the eye. You can use a control point, or you can use the arc tool, which is you'll click here and here and bring in this. So you click beginning and end and somewhere in the middle to fit that curve there. Okay, so we want to unlock the picture frame, we no longer need it, we can delete it. So now this is our image. You can continue to do on a control point if you want, but I'm good at this point. So I'm going to use a trim tool to cut the one in the middle. Okay, and while it's selected, I will join them. Now we have this head, but be aware of those corner, because when you doing the casting, you always don't want to have the sharp corner. So while before we do anything on that, I'm just gonna giving a fillet edges, fillet all the corner at once. Radius 0.5, which is fine. It doesn't change too much of the shape. Okay, so now I'm going to bring this close to where my ring is going to be. As rest of like the rest of the tutorial, I like to have a ring size, just set it for the demonstration purpose for diameter 16 or radius for 8. Okay, so that let's take a look on the perspective. All right, so that's where the position for the ring. And you can tilt the head a little bit more if you like to, but I'm gonna keep it like this so far at this point, and I can change it when they turn it into solid. Okay, the next things we wanted to do is we need to project this curve to the surface. So I'm going to create a surface first by picking up the ring size where that circle, and we are going to use the surface tool, extrude this curve, and we want to extrude it straight. Okay, so I want to extrude it that is covered entire of the fox curve image that we just draw. Okay, now make sure that you are on the top view. It's really important that when you're using a project, you need to be on the right window. Okay, correct window. So I'm going to use project curve. I'm gonna select all the curve that I have for this fox head, and then I'm going to project it to this surface. Okay, it feels like there's nothing changed on the top view, but if you look at the perspective view, let me turn into the ghost, then you will see they are here. Okay, I'm gonna pick up the one on the top and using the trim tool to trim the rest of the surface. Next step, we're going to turn this surface into solid. So we're gonna go into the solid, and then you have a command called extrude surface. We're gonna extrude the surface straight. So we're gonna pick up the surface and it will go up and down. I'm just gonna type it 1.2 here. And so I have the thickness for 1.2 to make it more comfortable. I would like to have all the edges kind of rounded. We are going to use the fillet, a solid fillet edges fillet command. And right here, because we were doing the radius for 0.5, so I want to make sure that the radius I'm going to use is less than 0.5. Otherwise, it's gonna get really crazy. Let me show you how crazy they can be. Let's say we're gonna do 0.6, and then you pick up this, and because this is really tight curve here, and so once you get it, it's gonna give you a lot of extra surface here. So we wanna make sure it's small enough, smaller than 0.5. I'm just gonna try 0.3 here, and then you can see it worked much better. And double make sure if it still it is solid on our property, showing this is still a closed poly surface. So excellent. Now we're gonna move those two up. I'm going to move it up a little bit above the surface right there. Okay, and basically we're just gonna pipe this guy. We are going to use the pipe tool, and I'm going to go to the pipe and pick up roughly about 0.2. That work. You can have a different radius on both ends. For me, I feel like the same radius look nicer in this case. All right, and all we need to do is balling difference the eye, or you can balling unit if you like to. Okay, so I'm gonna do the let's do the bowling unit this time. So click this, all three together. Now you have the eyes like this. Okay. All right, so we finished the head. We need to working on the ring shank. Okay, so the ring shank I'm going to do is using the helix. It's living under the curve tool, and then you have this one's called helix, okay? It will ask me where's the starting axis. I'm just gonna type it 0, enter, okay? And I'm going to, the next one, I'm gonna go from the top view. This is asking you where the axis is, and also how thick you want this ring shank to be. All right, we kind of just guessing about how big we want it to be. Now, it can be more turned if you want to, like, instead of double ring shank, you have want to have really thick, like 5 ring shank together. All you need to do is turn this into 5 instead of 2, right? So you can see there's a lot of circle, like a spring looking things here. What I like to do is keep it as a 2, more like a double ring shank. And I want to snapping into the quadrant. And this is what I get, right? Okay, so I'm going to move down the head, tilt it a little bit more to get a better position. All right, so temporarily, we're just gonna hide this curve so it doesn't bother us, and hide this curve as well. All right, so next what we wanted to do is doing the tail things here. I use the spiral, and make sure you use the flat spiral. And what I like to do is turn on my smart track so I can snapping into this end here, and you see that white line coming here, and that will be aligned to that point so I can know where my center is going to be. So you have this coming up, and I'm going to snapping into the end, right? And then you can choose like how big of the spiral you wanted to have. I'm just gonna eyeball it and look like it looks fine to me, all right? Now the only problem that we have is everything is following this ring shank. Let me turn it into the red color here. So everything is following this ring shank, it has really nice curve, but the spiral is not, okay? So what we can do is let's keep practicing on the project. This time, I'm going to, we have other way to do it, but I want you to practice on the project. So we wanna make a surface first, and let's go to the top view, and we pick up this curve, and then we want to project it to this surface, right? So if you look at my perspective view, you're going to see this a little bit change here. This was the original. We are going to delete. We are going to delete the surface as well. And this one is actually half the curvature, right? So I'm going to join those together. All right. So everything is said and done. We did it this one. Everything is said and done. I'm going to hide this curve. We no longer need it. All right, so all we need to do is pipe, right? Remember, you still need to trim inside of a ring shank. So if you use 1 millimeter as your thickness, after you trim inside, it's going to be 0.5 millimeter. So make sure you consider the size of your ring shank. So we're gonna use the pipe tool for this curve. We are going to find a pipe here. And then at first I'm going to type it 1 millimeter for the radius. At the very end, I want it to taper down. So type it 0.2 millimeter. And then right in the middle, I wanna make sure that it doesn't taper down like, in the average, I want to make sure that the thickness on the ring shank, they keep it 1 and maybe slightly tapered down until here. I want to type it 0.85. And from 0.85 to the tail, it is more dramatically tapered down. So then we got our ring shank. I'm going to bring back that curve that we have, because now half of the pipe is inside of a ring shank. So I'm going to extrude a planar curve straight and make sure that you want it to be on both sides. Make sure you want it to be solid, okay? And we want to do bowling difference. The piping, out of this cylinder. Okay, so inside of a ring shank will keep the same size for whatever your original tool plane to have. Okay, and then you can keep adjusting the head to find the best position for it. Something maybe a little bit offset like this. Okay, and you can do, or maybe a little bit higher, oh, whichever you think it works for you. And then just need to bowling to get a union together. So now you get the fox ring. I hope you enjoyed this fox ring tutorial using Rhino 3D software. Don't forget to like, comment, and share my video, and also subscribe my channel right below link. That helped me to create more free video for you. Thank you for watching. See you next time.